Longhand division. No more nice and neat polynomials for us. But it's still pretty cool. I bet many of you have never done this. The kids growing up nowadays? Who knows? I haven't been in school forever. But back in my day, what if you wanted to say 9,842 divided by 12? That's called get your calculator, right? We had another way to do it. I'm gonna have to write a little small. We wrote it like this. 12, do a little symbol. 9, 8, 4, 2. So we say, how many times does 12 go into 9? 0. 0 times 12 is 0, so we subtract, we're left with 9. That's called the remainder. Now, we bring down the 8. How many times does 12 go into 98? 8 times. What is 8 times 12? 96. 98 minus 96 is 2. Bring down the 4. How many times does 12 go into 24? It goes 2. 2 times 12 is 24. Subtract, that's a remainder of 0. Bring down the 2. How many times does 12 go into 2? That's 0. So that's 0 times 12 is 0. Subtract, and we're left with 2. Yes, you always want to have a long piece of paper when doing this. So let me go ahead and just start writing up here again. Well, we have a 2, right? We had 0, subtracted, and we had 2. And we want to bring down a digit. Well, we can add zeros. Point 0. So bring down a 0. 12 goes into 20 one time. Point 1. 1 times 12 is 12. 20 minus 12. 20 minus 12 is 8. So I've got 80. 12 goes into 80 6 times, which is 72. 6 times 12 is 72. Subtract, we get 8. Bring down a 0. And now we can see a pattern. We got 6, so we're going to get 72. We're going to get 8. We're going to bring down a 0. So it's 1.66 repeating. And that's how you do division. That's pretty much. And this is why we invented calculators. Just imagine having to use a log table and a slide rule. It would actually be faster to do that, but this is more accurate. But moving on, what in the world did I just do? So obviously we're still using the power of positional notation, but it's not quite so pretty. The operation we're doing is 9,842 over 12. So instead of doing the times 10 to the whatever, I'll just keep it like this. It'll be a little easier to see, because these numbers are small. What is this? This is 9,000 plus 842 divided by 12, which is 9,000 divided by 12 plus 842 divided by 12. So let's just worry about this 9,000. Remember how I said how many times does 12 go into 9? Well, it's not as easy to see how many times 12 goes into 9,000. But what if, let's just clear some space, and I say 9 times 10 to the 3 over 12. I lied, didn't I? Well, now we can split it as 9 over 12 times 10 to the 3. Well, 9 over 12, we don't get any 12s out of that. So that's why I wrote a 0 in the 10 to the 3rd place. 0820. But now what do we do with this? Well, I want to bring it down to the next order of magnitude. How do I do that? Well, 9 times 10 to the 3 is 90 times 10 to the 2. All of my markers are dying. And this is over 12. And then before we also had the 842 over 12. So we're back to our full operation now. So we can do 90 times 10 to the 2 plus 842 over 12. And you're saying, we've got nowhere. I'm showing you how this weird thing I did makes sense algebraically. Obviously, we don't do it this way. This is why we do it that way. That's why I did it that way. But what is 842? 842 is 800 plus 42. 800 is 8 times 10 to the 2. Now we can recombine that. And we have 98 times 10 to the 2, or 9800 plus 42 over 12. And we can split it up the same way. And now we're working with 98 over 12 times 10 to the 2. So this is just that step 2. Your eyes may be beginning to glaze over at this point. Don't worry. This is nothing that you should be learning. This is an illustration. This is me showing you so that you can go, wow, that's cool. Just kind of let it flow. Just see it happen. And don't worry too much about remembering it, because you don't need to know this. It's about the learning, not about what you learn. So now, what did we say? 98 and 12. 12 goes into 98 8 times. 98 equals 96 plus 2. So 98 over 12 is 96 plus 2 over 12, which is 96 over 12 plus 2 over 12, but we had that 10 to the 2. So now we have this times 10 to the 2, so now we put it back. Well, 96 over 12 is 8. We already know that. So we have 8 times 10 to the 2 plus 2 over 12 times 10 to the 2, but this is just 200 over 12, and this, of course, is 800. So now maybe you see where this starts to come from, because we had 12 9842 is 820, dot, dot, dot. So here's your 800, and what's the 200? The 200 was your remainder, because we wrote a 2 down here, but implied, because it's two spaces over, positional notation is 200. So that's all I was doing when I was saying, how much does 12 go into this digit or this pair of digits, and then multiply it back out and take the remainder, subtract, and bring a digit down. That was using positional notation to do all of this algebra, where we take 9,000 plus 842 out of 9,842. We just split it, pull off tens, add tens, do little Legos with all these numbers. The power of positional notation is that you can do all of that fancy algebra polynomial manipulation visually, just because of columns in a grid paper. So mostly I just wanted to impress you with how cool that is. This is something that we take for granted. I don't know how the kids nowadays do their longhand math, if they even do. Maybe they've given up and school just says, use a calculator. I don't know. I think it's important to be able to do longhand math, just because, at least small numbers, you know, better to do it quickly in your head than have to go get the calculator. You know, stranded on a desert island, whatever, but I'm not going to worry about it. But for me, it's just something that, until, you know, years ago, I never even thought about. When I started picking up on positional notation and thinking about, why does all this stuff work? All the stuff that we just learned. We learned these rules. You know, it's like the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. And then you learn it extends into infinite dimensions. And you just take people's words for it. And there's proofs. Oh, it's proven. If you want to learn the proof, more power to you. Enjoy, you know, your 6 years of college. So you absolutely can go through all of this, except 800 million times over, learning complicated math proofs. I've opted to just trust people, but I think it's great when something is within my realm of understanding, something that a bus driver can just sit here on a whiteboard or a piece of paper and work out and go, wow, that's pretty neat. So while you marvel at some of the little things in life we took for granted, the hidden depth, I'll be seeing you.